Good afternoon. Three men have been convicted of murdering five people in a shop explosion in Leicester. Aram Kurd, Arkan Ali and Hawker Hassan were also found guilty of conspiracy to commit insurance fraud. The arson attack happened in February this year and was caused by petrol demolishing a supermarket and two-story flat above. Mary Rago Beer died together with her teenage sons Shane and Sean, along with Shane's girlfriend Leah Reek and Arkan Ali's brother Victoria Eraleva. Well, let's go to our correspondent Jeremy Ball, who's outside Leicester Crown Court for us now. Jeremy.
Well, emotional scenes here, Simon, as these verdicts return. People were hugging, they were crying in the public gallery as the three men on trial were found guilty of both that fraud charge and five separate counts of murder. And this followed an investigation that the police have described here as heartbreaking and challenging. Catherine Stancheshin reports.
A massive explosion shatters a quiet Sunday evening. Shortly after 7 p.m. on the 25th of February, this building on one of Leicester's main roads was completely destroyed, leaving five dead. Mary Ragabeer, two of her teenage sons, Sean and Shane, and his girlfriend, Leah Reek, who'd been spending an evening together in their flat. Mary's youngest son, Scotty, was pulled from the rubble and survived, described in court as nothing short of a miracle. Also killed in the Polish store below it, shop worker 22-year-old Victoria Eevleva. She'd been conspiring with three men, Hawker Hassan, Arkan Ali and Aram Kurd. They deliberately caused the fire as part of a fraudulent insurance claim, hoping to make at least £300,000. This CCTV footage shows them buying more than 20 litres of petrol the day before the explosion. They also bought other flammable materials to intensify the fire.
I think there was clearly the element of planning, that greed, financial gain took over from anything else, and they were callous really as to whether human life was affected by what they did.
Aram Kurd ran the Polish supermarket. Prior to the explosion, he moved the CCTV camera outside the shop to obscure the view. Here he is at the scene just seconds afterwards. He'd been in the basement when it happened, then an hour later talking to police.
Yeah, just go through and then how it all come about.
The BBC spoke to him the day afterwards when it was unclear he was responsible.
And how are you feeling at the moment?
I don't know how to tell you. Never I feel... Oh, I am now.
This was a cynically planned fraud with deadly consequences. The threat to people's lives callously disregarded. Catherine Stancheshin, BBC News, Leicester.
And reaction here on the court steps in the last few minutes. The police said this was a crime that was motivated by greed, that robbed family and friends of a future. We heard tributes from the Ragabeer family and tributes too from Molly Reek, who's Leah's sister.
The light went out of our world on that terrible night, and it is so difficult to put into words how much we miss Leah. She was an amazing, inspirational young lady who was just starting out on her life adventure. Leah made a lasting impression on everybody lucky enough to know her. She was beautiful inside and out, and she truly shone when she entered a room. She was never aware of the impact that she had on so many just by smiling at them. We will always miss that smile, her laughter and those beautiful curls. Her happy outlook on life was contagious. We miss her terribly, and every second of every day we carry the pain of losing Leah. She has left a Leah-shaped hole in our hearts that nothing will ever fill, and we are broken. Leah was a very rare find, a genuine diamond who shone so brightly and made such a difference in society. It makes us angry and breaks our hearts that we'll never get the chance to see Leah reach her full potential in life. We know Leah worshipped Shane and they adored each other when they were taken from this world. We are so grateful to the Ragabeer family for making Leah so welcome. She loved being there, and knowing she was always happy there gives us some comfort. Leah's death has not just left us heartbroken, it has had such a ripple effect on so many people, friends, family and the Ragabeers. Our village Asford, being local town Melton Mowbray, have given us such amazing support and shown such kindness in our dark time. We are truly grateful. Leah will always love you, and the world is definitely a brighter, happier place with you in it.
And we heard in Catherine's report about Scotty Ragavir, the only person to survive this blast. Well, this morning the judge paid tribute to the policeman who rescued him from the rubble. The three men who murdered his mother and his two brothers, they're going to be back here to be sentenced on the 18th of January. Simon.
Thank you very much. That's Jeremy Ball outside Leicester Crown Court.